हेलो क्लास, नाउ वी विल सी द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द एसी चार्जिंग सिस्टम। सो दोज आर द कॉमन पार्ट्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन केस ऑफ द ऑल काइंड ऑफ परमानेंट मैग्नेट एसी चार्जिंग सिस्टम, वेदर इट इज फुल वेव और सॉरी वेदर इट इज सिंगल फेज और वेदर इट इज मल्टी फेज, ओके, और वेदर इट इज फुल वेव और हाफ वेव टाइप चार्जिंग सिस्टम। सो द फर्स्ट पार्ट in the charging system, that is alternator. The alternator mainly consists of two things. One is the rotor, another is the stator. So it may be, in case of AC generator, a rotor may be a permanent magnet or stator may be a permanent magnet. The thing is that the magnetic flux or the conductor should move with respect to each other, or they should cut each other. Doesn't mean that only magnetor should be a rotor or stator should be a rotor. So it may be any kind. So in case of the two wheeler, normally the ignition coil or the conductor are plays a role of stator, and the permanent magnet plays a role of your rotor. So here there is a permanent magnet. We can see this is a bowl or this is a flywheel cum magneto, we can say. Okay, so this is a this having a huge mass. Okay, inside here three pairs, or we can say three magnets are located in such a way, here and here as, here and here as, here and here as, in that fashion. Here we are total having three magnet located circumferentially inside this bowl. So this is a magneto bowl, we can say. Okay, on the magneto there are notches are present. So this is a notch, first notch, and this is a second notch. The first notch indicates and the second notch indicates the distance between this first notch and the second notch indicates, that is, range or timing of ignition, or we can say it indicates an angle of ignition. Means start from here to here, the ignition timing can be lie in between these two range, initial range to last range. Okay, or it depends, sometimes this bigger notch may be located prior to this one small notch. So range of ignition angle start from here to here. So as we are mentioning in wall timing diagram, the ignition take place 30 to 35 degree before TDC. So it is 10 to 35 degree before TDC is a range. Okay, so this is a range of ignition it indicates. Okay, on that basis ignition may take place in between this range. Okay, so this is your magneto consists of six permanent magnet on the circumferential inside this bowl. This magneto or this magnet is fixed to the crankshaft with the help of a key arrangement. After that come to the stator, that is coil. As I told you, there are various type of coils are present employed in case of our generator, or we can say charging system of two wheeler, such as a charging coil or lightning coil, we can say. After that, starting coil or exciter coil, we can say. And third one is pickup coil. So those three coils having their individual role. So charging coil or lightning coil are those which giving power supply or which developing power supply for charging the battery, or giving a power to accessories like light, horn. Okay, so in those system for charging purpose or rather for lightning purpose, it develop the power. So those coils are called as a charging or lightning coil. Some coils are used to give a power to CDI ignition system or CDI ignition system. So such a type of coils are called as a exciter coil, powered coil, और स्टार्टिंग कॉइल. ओके, सो ओनली डिफरेंस इन बिटवीन दोज टू टाइप ऑफ कॉइल, द एक्साइटर कॉइल और स्टार्टर कॉइल और पावर कॉइल आर हैविंग वेरी थिन गेज वायर एंड चार्जिंग कॉइल और लाइटनिंग कॉइल हैविंग समवॉट थिक गेज ऑफ वायर. ओके, एंड द थर्ड वन दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ पिकअप कॉइल. सो पिकअप कॉइल इज जस्ट टू ट्रिगर अवर सी डी इग्निशन सिस्टम विच सपोज टू कम्युनिकेट विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू दिस नॉचेस. ओके, सो वेन एवर दिस नॉच कम इन फ्रंट ऑफ दिस पिकअप कॉइल, ओके, सो दैट टाइम इट सपोज टू ट्रिगर अ सी डी इग्निशन. सो इन दिस वे थ्री इग्निशन सॉरी थ्री कॉइल्स आर अरेज इन साइड द स्टेटर यूनिट. ओके, सो दिस इज अ ब्लैक प्लेट बैक प्लेट ऑन विच यूर दिस थ्री type of coil supposed to locate. So there may be a different design. In this first design we can see all the coils are having equal thickness or equal gauge thickness of wire. Okay, so here only our charging and lightning coil are present. Okay, charging or lightning coil is present here, no any look position or design made or position located or arrangement made for the exciter or the power starting coil. So here only two type of coil may be present. One is a charging and lightning coil and another will be the pickup coil. So pickup coil, similarly whenever this thing is located on the back plate on this position of on this clamping position, pickup coil of this system will be located. So right now this is just dismantled from the back plate, so you are not able to locate your pickup coil, but pickup coil present with this system. Okay, now the other one is another system is this one. Here you can see you can differentiate three coil easily. This one is your charging or lightning coil, this one is your exciter powered or starting coil, and third one is the pickup coil. So in those three coil having their own individual work. So in our case for the charging system this coil supposed to work. Here in our case for the charging system those coils supposed to works. Now come to the third type. Here you can see a design is different but thing is same as this one. Okay, so here combination of these two, here we are using a third type. This is somewhat thick gauge wire indicating a charging or lightning coil. Here this two different or we can say the thin gauge wire coils are there. Okay, so those coils are called as exciter powered or starting coil, which is used to trigger a CDI ignition system. Okay, and this thick gauge wire are used to power lightning system or supposed to charge the battery. And third one, that is pickup coil, also it is not present here. Whenever this stator unit is supposed to locate on the back plate, that time on this clamp pickup will be located. So in this way these three type of stator, different stator and magneto make combinedly alternator system. Okay, so this one is the rotor, that should be a magnet. Okay, in case of two wheeler, and another is the stator in which supposed to your electricity get developed and that convert to your battery or other accessories. Okay, so this is the first part of our charging system. Now rectifier is a thing, as I told you this is the AC generator. Okay, so AC generator develop it's the electricity in the AC form, that is alternating current form, positive and negative cycle. Okay, alternating current. But as we know, our battery and other accessories on the vehicle are powered by DC source. Okay, so it won't run by AC supply, it run by DC power source. So in order to give a required power source, we should have to convert our AC system or AC current into DC current. So we have already seen in basic electrical and electronics there is a two type of rectifier unit is there. One is a full wave rectifier unit is there and there is a half wave rectifier unit is there. It consists of the diodes which having a unidirectional flow current or which used to guide a current in only one direction. Okay, so the basic work of the rectifier is to convert AC current into DC current. So here in the first circuit diagram, you can see the your half wave rectifier, and in second circuit diagram you can see a full wave rectifier. So suppose this is your AC generator. Okay, AC generator means it continuously changing its polarity. Okay, so AC generator is there. AC generator is there. So this is your AC generator, and it connected parallel to our battery source. The battery source need to be a charge, and this is a AC generator which developing the power in order to charge your battery. So here consider, initially this is a positive, this is negative. Okay, so electron supposed to flow positive to negative. Okay, so this is a diode in a forward bias. Forward bias means the direction of diode align with a flow of current, or we can say the direction of arrow of this diode are aligned in the direction of flow of current. So we can say it is a forward bias. If it is in opposite direction, then this become in reverse bias. So on that basis we can see it is now forward bias. This is a positive side, this is a negative side of AC generator right now. So current supposed to flow in this fashion. Okay, it's supposed to enter in battery terminal positive and exit from the negative terminal of battery in this way for the first power cycle. For this power cycle your electricity is drawn. Now for the remaining power, for the other half cycle, this side become negative and this side become positive. Now polarity changes of AC generator, this current now start to flow in reverse direction. Okay, now here it's supposed to stuck. Okay, it's supposed to stuck. So what happened here, for the this reverse cycle we are getting a flat spot, no flow of current. As the diode is there, it not allowed to flow or complete the circuit. So we are getting a flat cycle over here. Whether your AC generator is developing the current, it developing a negative sinusoidal wave, but in here in resultant rectified current we are getting a positive cycle, as we are getting a flow this way. Whenever negative cycle start due to change in polarity, we are our diode supposed to restrict the flow and we are getting the flat cycle. So for only half cycle battery getting a charge, or battery supposed to charge only for half cycle, means if your magneto is rotating 360 degree, that is one complete revolution. So for 180 degree only your battery is charging, remaining 180 battery is not charging. So you are getting such a type of supply, 180 power source, another 180 flat, 180 power source and another 180 flat. So this way you are getting the half wave of charging. So that's why we are calling as a half wave rectifier. Another half get vanished because diode not allowed to flow this across him, that current across him it won't allow. Okay, so this is the only half wave of half wave to charging we are getting in case of the half wave rectifier. So that's why frequency is less, behind one cycle only once we are getting a charging cycle. So frequency is there. Now we will see what is a full wave rectification. Now in case of the full wave rectification, similarly here we are using a bridge rectifier. Four diodes are used here. Okay, now consider first polarity, that is this side positive. Okay, and this is a negative. So in here current is supposed to flow, see the dotted arrow, current flow supposed to this way. Okay, now it won't flow in this direction because here diode direction is, this diode become in or we can say this diode are in position of reverse bias. So it won't go to reverse bias, it go to the forward bias diode. So this is in the direction of forward bias, dotted line enter to here, positive to negative of battery. After that it reaches to bridge rectifier again. Now Again, this is the way and this is also way, but this way guided to negative side, so it go to positive side. In this way, you are getting the one complete cycle. In this way, we have completed the or we can say we have closed loop cycle for first 180. If this is a wave behind the one revolution of generator or one revolution of magneto, so this is a cycle completed for the first 180. Okay, so here we are getting, this is a first half cycle output for the first half cycle. Now remaining 180 degree, that is negative cycle, here polarity changes, so this become negative side and this become positive side. Now current supposed to flow in opposite direction, above direction. Okay, so now consider that dark black line, so supposed to flow in this way. Now here it reaches to bridge rectifier. Now here it either go this way or this way, but in that way the diode is reverse bias, this one is in forward bias, so it's supposed to move in along with this diode. Okay, it intending to the battery positive to negative, again it come back to your bridge rectifier. Again bridge rectifier, here you are having a two diode in forward bias, this one and this one, but here it guiding it to negative side, that is this one, so it won't go through this one, it travel through this way and reach back to your positive side of generator. So in this way it complete the next half cycle of one revolution. So this negative side also we are getting the another positive loop after the rectification. So here we are getting the two half cycle, in that way complete one cycle of charging. Okay, first half for this one, that is this, and for negative half it is this one. So here we are getting the, in one revolution we are getting the two charging cycles. Okay, but here is not like that. For one revolution we are getting only one half cycle, another half cycle is blank, again half cycle blank, half cycle in that way, but here not like that, we are continuously getting the cycles of charging. Okay, so in that way this is called as a full wave rectifier, full wave rectification. Okay, so here we have seen two parts of our charging system. One is a rectifier and is an alternator. Remaining two parts we will see in next video. Thank you.